HOK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
That's context name. Okay, project name or context name. Now, this is where you need a name of this particular servlet. Okay, so this URL will be constant for all the application which will be hosted, or all the URLs which will be hosted for this particular project. Now, I need to hit this first servlet. So, let me have the name as first. So, this is my URL. I decided this is the URL and this will hit first servlet. Okay, so my URL is first. It will hit first servlet. Okay, we have to do this particular mapping somewhere. Okay, that this URL means this servlet. Okay, we do that in deployment descriptor. This is where web.xml actually takes an important role. Okay, let's delete this all stuff, we don't need it. Okay, so this is deployment descriptor, that is web.xml. In web.xml you have to mention that this URL is mapped to this servlet. First is mapped to first servlet. This is what we're gonna do. Okay, how do we do that? We do that with the help of, first thing is we use servlet mapping. Okay, so we map the servlet and we tell that, okay, this is the servlet name and URL path. So servlet name is some name which we define to the servlet. We give the name to the servlet. How do you give a name to the servlet? So to give the name to the servlet, we use servlet tag. So servlet, which has servlet name, and I give the name first. And servlet class. Now you will use com dot h2k dot web dot first dot first servlet. Okay, so what I'm doing here, I'm just mentioning that this servlet has a name first. Okay, or not for confusion, for removing the confusion, name it as first servlet itself, because our URL is also first, right? So for removing confusion, I just named it as a first servlet, just F small. Okay, now I have to map this first servlet to the URL pattern as first. So let me copy this name, map it here, and tell this guy that the URL is first. So whatever coming as a slash first, it will come to first servlet, which in turn, this is the class. Okay, so this mapping is important. This is called as servlet mapping. If I change the display name of this project, okay, then context of that project will be changed. URL will be affected. Yes. Okay, now let's run this particular servlet on our entire project on Tomcat. So run as, run on server. This is how you do that. Always run on Tomcat. Okay, you can see that it's configured, match web project, and finish it. This will start the server. This is gonna take some time. I got a warning that my mic is too loud. Takes little time. No, no, I'm not reducing any volume. Takes little time, but it started now. You can see that this is started on 8081 and HTTP localhost 8081 March web project. This is what it's hitting. And I need a URL pattern. I give URL pattern as first. This is what I'm going to give here. So just writing FIRST first and hit it. Okay. So I don't see any response here, but I can definitely see something here in it. Method I am first servlet. So this is what I was expecting because this is my init method. Remember that? Init method I am first servlet that is introduced, so that introduced variable is in served, and doGet method is also called when I hit the URL. I told you that it's a service method, so service method means it will serve forever. Now remember, init method will be called only once, just like constructor. Okay, so init method will be called only once, just like constructor. If I hit the URL again, I am not going to see this sentence, init method I am first servlet. I am only seeing in doGet method of a first servlet. And if I repeat calling that same URL again and again, I am going to repeat this particular stuff. To check that, I am just clearing out and hitting this URL again, so you will be able to see what's the result of it. doGet method, doGet method, doGet method, and continues to serve. This is exactly what is expected. So your servlet will be serving forever till it's alive in Tomcat. Once Tomcat shuts down, only then. Okay, and that to be proper shutdown, and we do not have any option for proper shutdown here. We have this terminate. So termination will not call destroy method, believe me. So if I call terminate, it will not call destroy method at all, and it will be immediately stopped. So I don't have a response of destroy method here. Okay, but there are ways in Unix boxes. In Windows we don't have that good way of termination, but in Unix boxes, whenever we do proper shutdown of a Tomcat machine in production or QA boxes, then you do see destroy method is getting properly called. Okay, question still now. This is important, the life cycle of a servlet. So we initialize the servlet, we hit it with the URL, our web.xml entries to map a particular servlet with the URL. Let's go through the material and see what are the things we have here. There is a short explanation what exactly init does, service does. Same thing whatever I told you. Each time the server receives a request from the servlet, server spawns a new thread and calls a service method. Okay. doGet, doPost are most frequently used methods in each of the service requests. Yeah, it will call. Yeah, that is completely true. If you are calling shutdown.bat, it will definitely call destroy. Okay, you can check that too. That's a proper shutdown. Okay, how does doPost look like? Exactly same, nothing changes. And let me show you right here. How does doPost look like? You can see that it will be exactly the same. Okay, or just write doPost, and there is merely a difference between how doGet looks and how doPost looks, except how they handle the request and response. Okay, of course I can make it public. There is no logic. You can use protected one, although it will be only used by a servlet and a Tomcat container, so it's okay to have it's protected. Just I was making it public because of my comfort zone. I like these methods as public. Now there is a huge confusion that which method will be called if I have both the methods. If I have doGet and doPost, which method will be called when I hit a URL? Okay, any guess? Okay, somebody else? I know Meena knows it. DoGet will be called, yes, that's true. Because DoGet, get is a default method. Okay, so if you don't mention an HTTP method, it's a default method. There are some things my Tomcat loads because of initial configurations and other applications which I work on side by side. So that also gets loaded. Don't worry about them. Okay, now I have doGet and doPost both. So if I hit the URL now, I'm going to get doGet method only. I'm not going to get doPost. I will tell you how to call doPost later with the help of HTTP methods. I will write a small HTML page which is calling that particular doPost method. We can do that. We will do it. Okay, and there is a code which I want you to test with yourself. Test in your box, test in your Eclipse, try this code actually, hello world. So this example, that's why I did not take. Okay, this example discuss about something to write the response on the HTML page actually. So that we're gonna do right now. So to write something on the response box. So as of now, I'm not writing anything here. So whatever we are, let me close, stop this server. Okay, we will see both the things now, how to get a request parameter and how to take a response parameter. Okay, how to give a response parameter. For that, we will use doGet example. So as of now, I'm just eliminating this sysout. Just understand first how to send a response. As of now, somebody is hitting the first servlet, and as soon as it hit, I want something to give it back to the HTML page. So first thing is you have to tell that what exactly you are sending. So response object has a lot of methods which are actually created to send a response in a different format. So first thing I am telling them is what content type I am sending. Okay, and that is called a MIME type, text/HTML. Okay, this is not important. You can ignore this and still you can get the proper result because by default browser parses everything in HTML. Okay, so this is not important if you are sending only HTML. If you are sending which is really different, like if you are sending a PDF file, you have to tell that it's application/PDF. Okay, so that is also possible. There are huge number of MIME types, and for that you need to Google HTTP MIME types. Hindi translator. Complete MIME type list. You can open any or you can use a wiki. Multipurpose internet mail extensions. And you can see there is a huge list. Application video.3gpp, 3gpp2 application.vnd, and a lot of stuff. What is commonly used for a C application/PDF. Okay. This list is really huge. We don't need this much. What we need is basically text/HTML, text/PDF, some small stuff here and there. Okay. So now as of now, we are just sending text/HTML. This will let your browser know what are you sending and what should be considered. You are sending text it should be considered as HTML. This is what you are sending. So content type is set. Now you need something to write that object on the page. Okay, so there is a object called as print writer. Okay, we did not see IO classes. Okay, once we have IO classes done, after our JSP and servlets, we have file operation sessions. So file IO. So once that file IO is done, you will know about this print writer very detailed manner. So we have something called as print writer object. Print writer. This object is responsible for writing objects into the files. Okay. This is like a file writer. Okay. So print writer is used. You can get an object of print writer from the response. Okay. So just get it print writer and call it as writer. And you can say ask response object to give me a writer. So response give me a writer object, and whatever I am going to write, it will be written in the response. Okay. And now just write HTML page, whatever HTML you want to write. So writer dot write. Okay, and you can write HTML code here. HTML body H1 welcome students. Okay, close that HTML properly. So writer dot write. HTML. Oh, sorry. First H1 will be closed. H1 is a header tag. Then body will be closed. And then HTML will be closed. Okay. So this is a standard HTML. If you want to separate it, if you want HTML tags in a separate, your body tags in a separate, H1 tags. So there's a completely fine, you can do whatever you want there. Okay. Just make sure all the tags you're starting should be ended. Okay. So you're literally writing HTML inside Java. Okay. And this is what is actually